I am Eduardo Solis, and I've spent the last 10 years or so fixing computers for a living. Over those 10 years, I've seen some things. Silly things, screwy things, scary things, and some just plain weird things. Behind every broken computer is the person who probably broke it, and so I give you the Tales of Tech Support. Breaking up is harder to do than you think. I've been laid off a few times during the course of my tech support career, so this is a topic that I know more about than I wish I did. Bouncing around from contract job to contract job is a thing in this 21st century, especially when you work in technology. Now, if the company you're working for has their business together, you know when the contract is going to be over and when your shift ends on that last day, you give the boss your badge, shake hands, maybe trade phone numbers, and exit the building, likely never to return. If you work the second shift or the third shift, then your day ends with no fanfare and a badge left on the boss's desk on the way out. I worked the overnight shift at one job and my last day ended on Sunday morning. Obviously, this was going to be a leave my badge on the boss's desk on my way out thing, so I went in as usual and signed into my PC. Or at least I tried to. Upon typing in my username and password, I was greeted with a message saying that my account was no longer active. This wouldn't have bothered me a whole lot, but I still had 8 hours of work to do and I was the only person on the shift. Fun thing was, the morning shift started at 6 in the morning and our tech support guys didn't come in until 8, so I crossed my fingers and hoped that nothing blew up for 2 hours. Fortunately, nothing did blow up during those first 2 hours of my shift, but if something had, it would have been an interesting last day to say the least. I used to joke about how when somebody in the office is going to be fired, somebody from HR will come to their cubicle with a security guard and a cardboard box. While I haven't had the unfortunate luck of having that happen to me, yet, it happened to my cube neighbor once who had an unfortunate habit of frequently showing up to work late. One morning, I overheard somebody from HR come to my neighbor's cube and tell her that the powers that be had decided that they were going to have to part ways. I did my best to not listen to the unfortunate proceedings happening on the other side of the cube wall, but I couldn't help but listen once the poor person started crying. At one point, the HR guy casually walked over to my side of the wall and asked me how I was doing. I answered, "Busy, very busy, sorry, but I can't talk right now," lest the axe come swinging in my direction. The axe actually would come swinging in my direction a few months later, but my boss at least had the decency to call me over to his office and spare my new cube neighbor the awkwardness. Much has been made as of late about quiet quitting. I don't know if being quiet fired is a thing, but I'm pretty sure that's what happened at one contract job where the management was so disorganized that they didn't bother to tell me when my last day was. The Friday that I thought was my last day was fast approaching, so I sent an email to my lead, my boss, and even the gal at the staffing agency. I got nothing but dead silence from all three, so I figured that was that, so I stayed home the following Monday and updated my resume. Now, if you're wondering why I didn't come in on Monday, this was a job where I had to wake up at 5:30 in the morning to start a 1-hour drive to the job site, so I didn't want to make the trip just for them to tell me that I was out of a job. I figured that if I was supposed to be there, they would call me. It wasn't until late Tuesday afternoon that I got an email saying, "Oh yeah, we need you for the rest of the week." Yeah, that would have been good to know the week prior so I didn't miss out on 2 days of work and pay. In 2020, I was working at a technical school as their tech guy, and life was pretty good. When COVID soon reared its ugly head and lockdown kicked in, we were all sent to work from home. Remember back in March of 2020 when we all thought COVID was going to blow over in a few months? God, we were beyond naive back then. Unfortunately for me, with every campus tech working from home now, we had way too many techs. After an initial rush of getting everybody set up, we were lucky to even get one ticket a week. 99.9% of my workday was spent checking my email, refreshing our ticketing website, and keeping an eye on our team chat for something to do. About a month into working from home, I was lucky enough to have a ticket drop into my bucket, which made me happy as I began to do some work. I started to research the issue and thought over potential solutions to the problem when a chat message came from my boss asking me if I had time for a meeting. He's the boss. Of course I have time for a meeting. I took a moment to make sure I was presentable and signed into the meeting. Three people popped up on my screen, my boss and two other individuals that I had never seen before. The instant I saw the two newbies, I was 99% sure that I was about to be let go. My boss introduced the two newcomers and went back to his computer to let the other two guys give me the bad news. I mean, really, he literally just went back to his desktop and back to work, while the other two somber-looking gentlemen introduced themselves as being from HR. Yeah, it was definitely game over, man. The only question now was whether I was fired or whether I was going to be laid off. After introducing himself, HR guy number one said, "I'm sorry that this is the first time we're meeting, Mr. Solis." I almost cracked the joke despite the gravity of the proceedings. It was right on the tip of my tongue and it took all my restraint to not reply with, "Well, if it makes y'all feel any better, this is also going to be the last time we're meeting." I decided to be a professional and held my tongue. Sure enough, I was laid off, which didn't come as a big surprise to me. One thing though, I will always think back to that moment when maybe it wouldn't have hurt to be a little silly. Or maybe it would have, I really don't know. And unfortunately for me, the few times that I've been fired have always gone off without a hitch. Go figure. This has been the Tales of Tech Support. Please like, subscribe, and remember, what some call quiet quitting is more correctly called doing the job. Any resemblance to actual events or locales of persons or companies living or dead is entirely coincidental. I am Eduardo Solis, and I thank you for listening. Be good, take care, and God bless.